Hello everyone, I am Suganya, Assistant Professor, PG and Research Department of English, St. Joseph College of Arts and Science, Autonomous, Curlew. In this video, we will discuss about resume writing. Resume is a short document used to summarize a job seeker's experience and qualifications for a prospective employer. Resume includes the job seeker's contact information, work experience, educational qualification, and relevant skills in support of a job application. When you apply for a job, you have to apprise or inform the job provider about eligibility, fitness the job as per. You prepare a short statement of important details about yourself, your educational qualifications, and other achievements. Such a statement is known as a curriculum vitae, commonly referred to as a CV. What is CV? A CV, short for Latin phrase a curriculum vitae, which means a course of life, is a detailed document highlighting your professional and academic history. CVs typically include information like work experience, achievements and awards, scholarships or grant you have earned, coursework, research projects and publications of your work. You may be asked to submit a CV when applying for a job in an academic or a job outside. It's very helpful. What is difference between a resume and CV? A CV is different from resume. A CV can run up to 7 to 8 pages, whereas a resume should be as brief, 2 pages at most. A resume is a shorter form document that provides a concise overview of your previous roles, skills and details about your educational qualification. But a CV, on the other hand, it's a typically a longer, more detailed document focused largely on academic coursework and research. How to write a CV? CV should be specific to your background and the job for your applying. There are several steps you can take to ensure you write an effective CV. Most CVs include contact information, academic history, professional experience, qualifications and skills, awards and honors, publications, grants and fellowships, license and certificates, personal information, hobbies and interest. These all informations are important to write CV. Now I give some important tips and techniques to write a CV and resume. Tip number 1, include your contact information. This includes your full name, phone number and email address. Including your physical address is optional. Okay. Second one, detail your academic history in reverse chronological order. These can include your postdoctoral programs, graduate school, undergraduate school and high school. Only include your most recent 2 educational experiences. Record your professional experience. List the company or organization, job title and dates employed starting with your most recent job. List your job duties, experience gained and achievements. Include relevant skills and qualifications. This can be in a separate skill section. List honor and awards. Include relevant publications and presentations. You can use powerful language and action verbs to describe the full range of your skills, so that the employer takes interest in your value and you get an upward career growth. What are the parts of a CV or resume? Here, there are 7 parts information SCB or resumes should include. First one, personal details. Second, educational qualification, employment, skills, interest and achievements, personal profile, reference. These seven parts is very important to write a CV or resume. What are the important rules to write a CV or resume? First, limit the length of the CV or resume to suit the need. Be brief. Your CV should not be over 1 or 2 pages long. Use white paper. Format with good printing quality. Use an easy to read font and enough spaces. Don't do it in handwriting. Unless it's required by the enterprise, a printer version is better. Avoid many formats and colors. Your CV should be professional. You can use the bold format to make everything clear and put emphasis titles. Leave spaces between section and writes only one side of the paper. Watch the style and avoid spelling mistakes. It's very important. Use synonyms and avoid repetitions. It's recommended not to use abbreviations. Remember, computer skills are necessary for all jobs today. Let there not be any gap in your career if you are using chronological format. Use a different resume format, not a chronological. There is a gap. Make the cover letter as good as your CV or resume. Be positive. You don't have to need to explain failures. Show the best of yourself, but in a brief and simple way. Thank you for watching this video.